Hey guys, my name's Cal, and in today's Swift and Xcode tutorial, we are going to be filtering our table view example based on some filter buttons and also going to be able to search it by some text. In a previous tutorial, I showed you guys how to build a table view, so you probably want to have some sort of table view before you get started on this video. If you don't have a table view already implemented, go check out the video. There's a link in the description. Otherwise, we're just going to use a UI search controller to search our list, and we're also going to implement some scope buttons, which are essentially just filter buttons. So rather than the user having to type in some selected things, if we already sort of have a rough idea of what they want to search for or how they want to filter the list, implementing some scope buttons is a great idea. As this is a search and filter tutorial, in order to start this tutorial, you just want to have a populated table view. First thing I'm going to do is create a navigation controller. Just drag and drop that in there. And the navigation controller automatically creates a table view. We're just going to delete that one because we've already got one. And then I'm going to drag across the storyboard entry point to our navigation controller. And then from our navigation controller, I'm going to link it up with our view controller. So I'm just going to right click and drag onto our table view controller and say root view controller. Cool. And you can see it's given that little bit of extra space. So basically this is our nav bar. And we can give it a title. So I'm just going to call the table view controller, I'm going to call it shapes, and I'm going to call the detail one detail. Next, we're going to head back into our table view controller.swift file, and I'm just going to declare our search controller. So I'm just going to say let search controller equal to UI search controller. And then in our view did load, we're going to create a method called init search controller. Inside our init search controller method, we're going to, well, you guessed it, we're going to initialize our search controller. I'll highlight all of the ones that are essential. There are a few lines here that you won't even need to implement. They're just purely look and feel sort of adjustments. So, you know, enables return key automatically and UI return key type of done. You could just leave those and you'll get the default. Here we're assigning navigation item search controller to the search controller that we just created. Here we're going to declare our filter buttons. So I'm just going to say search controller.searchbar.scope button titles is equal to, and then we're just creating an array list of strings. And finally, I'm going to say our search controller.searchbar delegate is self. So the view controller, our current table view controller, basically it's the view controller's responsibility to make sure that the search bar and the search controller works. And as of right now, our view controller doesn't do that. That's why it's throwing us these errors. So what we're going to do is just click on the error and hit fix for both of those search results updater and the search bar delegate. And all that we did there was basically put in these two lines. So our table view controller now implements UI search bar delegate and UI search results updating. And as of right now, our table view controller class does not conform to UI search bar delegate protocol. So click on the error message and say add protocol stubs. And I'm going to put this method down the bottom. Heading back up to the top, I'm just going to create another array of shapes. So this one's called filtered shapes. Cool. And then in our update search results method, I'm just going to declare our search bar. So let search bar equal to search controller.searchbar. Next, we're going to declare another variable. This is called scope button, or it should really be called selected scope button. And then we're just going to say scope button is equal to search bar.scope button titles, and then search bar.selected scope button index. So just getting our selected filter essentially. And then we're going to say let search text equal to search bar.text. We've got both of the user inputs, so we know what the user has searched for by their search text, and we know which scope button or filter button they've selected. Now we need to filter our list based on those parameters. So we're going to create a method for this. It receives search text and scope button, both of which are strings, and the scope button default is all. Inside this method, we're going to say filtered shapes is equal to shape list.filter. So go through each of the shapes in the shape list. Next, we're creating a boolean. We're checking to see if the scope button is all or the scope button is equal to our current shape name. Next, we're going to create an if statement to check if there's something in the search text. So just saying search controller.searchbar.text is not equal to nothing, essentially. And then we're going to say let search text match, so another boolean. And it's going to be true if shape name to lowercase contains our search text lowercase. So just checking to see what's in the search text, if it matches our current shape name. We're just going to return if our scope match and our search text match are both true, then this shape should be in our filtered list. So we're going to put our current shape into our filtered shapes list. I'm just going to say else, and in this scenario, we know there's nothing in the search text, so we're just going to return our scope match. So if it matches our scope, then we're just going to reload the data. So shape table view dot reload data. Next, we just need to make some adjustments to our table view protocol stubs. So in our number of rows in section method, we're just going to say if search controller is active, return our filtered shapes dot count instead of just our shapeless count, otherwise return our shapeless count. And in our index path, we're just going to create an if statement saying if our search controller is active, get this shape from filtered shapes and otherwise get it from shape list like we've been doing. And we're going to do the exact same thing for our segue. So I'm just going to copy that chunk of code and put it down where we've got selected shape and then refactor this shape to be selected shape. Just a quick typo fix up here. I spelled square wrong. And also the other thing is we're going to say shape name dot lowercase contains our scope button lowercase rather than being equal to exactly. That's just going to work for our rect abbreviation scope button or filter button. Cool, but if we build and run this now, you can see we've got the search tab at the top there. If you click on that, you can filter based on the different little filter tabs and the segue should work. And we can also type in a little bit of text and you can see that the search controller and the scope buttons all work together. So that was an example of how to search and filter a table view using Swift and Xcode 12. If you like this Swift and Xcode tutorial, let me know. Otherwise, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Cheers.